A question I often get asked by my clients looking to build or buy in different communities in Southwest Florida is what is a CDD, often referred to as a community development district. So in this video, I'm going to explain exactly what a CDD is, how long they last, and some of the advantages and disadvantages of buying into a community that has an established CDD. So stay tuned. If you've been shopping for homes in Southwest Florida, especially looking at new construction communities, you've likely heard the term CDD, which stands for Community Development District. You often find these in communities that have a lot of amenities and a lot of infrastructure, with things like resort-style pools, fitness centers, or even dog parks. But not all communities have CDDs. A CDD allows the developer of a new construction community to finance the upfront cost of utilities, infrastructure, and amenity centers by taking out municipal bonds from the county. Those bonds are paid back by the homeowners of the neighborhood on their annual tax bill. Bond repayment makes up the biggest portion of the annual cost and is often paid off in periods of 20, 25, or even 30 years. A common misconception is that CDDs eventually go away, but that's not entirely true. You see, a CDD is comprised of two components. First, you have the debt servicing on the bond, and then you have the operations and maintenance. The debt servicing on the bond is typically paid off in periods of 20, 25, or even 30 years. If you're looking at a resale community and you want to know what is left on the annual CDD, you can find that information on my website, zachrosen.com. Now, when it comes to operations and maintenance, those fees never go away because things like lakes, utilities, and amenities need that ongoing maintenance. Now, if you live in a community that has a lot of amenities and no CDD, that just means that the maintenance is included in your HOA payments. New home builders without CDDs love to include that in their marketing materials and signage, but someone has to pay for all that infrastructure and all those amenities, so it's likely included in the upfront cost of the home or paid for via one-time fees. But having a CDD can be an advantage because it spreads that cost over 20 or 30 years, later paid back on your annual tax bill. Looking at it from another perspective, a CDD can be a good thing, because why prepay for the infrastructure for the next homeowner if you don't plan on staying in the home for 20 to 30 years? But the counter argument to that is that those who do pay for the infrastructure upfront and don't have a CDD will always recoup those costs in the sale of their home. Ultimately, CDDs are a popular way for new construction developers to bring beautiful infrastructure and great amenities to the neighborhood without the huge upfront cost to the homeowner. I hope you found this information informative. If you're thinking about building a home in a new construction community in Southwest Florida, I encourage you to reach out to me directly. I can help you with things like lot selection, option selection, and even the things you didn't even think about to ask. The last thing you want to do is build a home with a pool that has poor sun exposure. Have you thought about what kind of exposure your lot selection is going to have? So reach out to me directly. 239-691-6811 or via email at zach@zachrosen.com. You can find valuable resources on my website at zachrosen.com. And if you're watching this on YouTube, be sure to subscribe to my channel so you can get all the upcoming video tours. If you're watching this video on Facebook or Instagram, be sure to follow my page so that you can stay up to date on all my upcoming videos and community tours. We'll see you next time.